super fun stuff.
In today's video, I'm going to show you my latest 3D model adventure. Now, if you saw some of my latest videos, you know that I have created a new 3D modeling store on myminifactory.com. I offer up a lot of free models as well as some paid models. Recently, I've gone between wargaming hobbies like 40K and 3D printing stuff like the Fly from Hotel Transylvania, the Mare from Nightmare Before Christmas, and the original Kazoom. Speaking of the original Kazoom, I've gone towards a musical route, creating stuff for musical instruments or instruments themselves. The original Kazoom is the world's first telescopic kazoo. And I made the capo can. It's a capo for a guitar, but it can also hold a canned drink. Lastly, the Queen of Hearts guitar picks are interesting picks that work awesome in heat color changing PLA. All originally were conceived to be a crazy dumb idea that actually ended up being quite cool. Like the original Kazoom, it actually works really well. Who would have thunk it? Going with the musical route, I've decided to create a full-blown instrument. An instrument that is pretty awesome and doesn't get a lot of love. I picked the Hurdy Gurdy. Some of you may recognize the instrument, and some of you may have no clue. The Hurdy Gurdy is a medieval instrument that looks similar to a violin or guitar, but has some distinct functions. First, it has a giant wheel that you spin with a crank at the base of the instrument. The wheel rubs across the strings to make sound, similar to how a reed rubs against the strings of a violin. Another major difference is the key box. Instead of holding the strings down like a guitar or any other instrument with your hands, there are little push-in keys that put pressure on the melody strings with little pegs called tangents. This is kind of like a piano in the aspect that you hit a key to hit a string. There are also other strings that can be used to create buzzing sounds when played. They're called drone strings. There's also a wheel cover and a movable bridge called a dog. That's to get the strings just right to hit the wheel. So even though the hurdy-gurdy is like other string instruments, there are very distinct differences, and quite a few movable parts. When you play a hurdy-gurdy, it really takes you back in time. It has a unique sound and feels like you're at a Renaissance fair. Searching on other 3D printing sites, there's a very few things relating to this instrument. The only design that actually did anything for the hurdy-gurdy is called the nerdy-gurdy. This combines some 3D printed parts with a wood structure. However, it has very minimal 3D printed parts and requires you to pay for a wood kit to make. Being the cheap ass that I am, that wasn't going to happen. Why not create my own fully 3D printed hurdy-gurdy? Introducing the world's first fully 3D printed hurdy-gurdy and the world's smallest hurdy-gurdy. I call it the Mini Giddy. The Mini Giddy is a hurdy-gurdy that will utilize two strings, four keys, and a basic hurdy-gurdy design. Pocket-sized instruments like the original Kazoom are awesome. They're easily portable and fun. I want to make this very similar. It may not be fully pocket-sized, unless you have big pockets, but it's a tiny addition that shows the concepts of a hurdy-gurdy. It's a bare-bone design, and it features 46 parts. Still can't believe I made all those parts, and all of them interconnect. The only thing not 3D printed are pegs and the strings. Definitely need some metal parts for those for the right tension and sound. There's also a small screw that will help you adjust the dog, aka the adjustable bridge. For this project, I used Tinkercad. For things like this, this tool is awesome. Everything was made with some sort of primitive, and designed for easy printing. There are only two or three parts that require some type of support material, and every part is designed to fit on most printer bed sizes. A lot of thought and design went into the Mini Giddy, and I'm in process of printing out my own to test right now. If I didn't run out of filament, I would be near done now, but whatever, it's coming. You can see here that the parts marked as green are finished and ready to be used. The yellow means I have to reprint it, and the red means it hasn't been started yet. As I said, each part is interconnecting. However, I do want to make it super sturdy, so this will be using a strong glue. I also made some tight tolerances, especially the rod that spins the wheel, so sanding is going to be a must. The perimeter of the wheel also needs to be super smooth, so again, more sanding will be done. With the size, I could fit four decent sized keys. I could have made more, but I didn't want them super tiny. I got fairly big fingers, and I want anyone to be able to play this. The Mini Giddy uses two melody strings, and no drone strings. One, due to size, two strings is about all I could fit, and adding a drone string just complicates things. Plus, I'm not a huge fan of that buzzing sound anyway. This is designed to be small, fun, functional, and allows anyone to learn and play. Plus, I think I come up with some great names. Mini Giddy, Hurdy Gurdy, oh yeah. So what do you think? I never share any model or things on my 3D printing store without testing them first. I know a lot of other modelers put things on 3D sites quicker, but I like to take my time and ensure everything works as intended. Hopefully by the end of the week, I'll have everything printed, and then I can make another video on how I put it together and really test this guy out. If it sounds bad, maybe I can call it the Hurdy Gurdy. So stay tuned for future things I make and for more updates regarding the Mini Giddy. While waiting on more filament, I've already started another 3D printed project, specifically for War Game Miniature Worlds. Can't wait to share that one with you.